Adeboy Adedoyin Adesoji, that's the name I'm called. Jazzyb, that's my TV name. Dreams come true with Jazzyb. That's a program I host on TV meant to empower you to fulfill your dreams. Come along with me. To you today, that yet you find something worth dying for, then you are not fit to leave. Come on, folks. Join me every third Sunday of the month, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Let's just go get our dreams come true.
It's the biggest and most empowering youth talk show on TV. Dreams come true with Jazzyb. Highly entertaining, purely educating, and touching true stories. Let's learn from their dreams, their fears, the struggles, the disappointments, the failures, and their gains. All because of their dreams. But after all, their dreams came to reality. Dreams Come True Talk Show with Jazzyb on this channel.
Welcome to another wonderful and interesting episode of Dreams Come True, and I'm still your host, Jazzyb. Just say good morning. Well, it could be morning for some of you in the part of in the whatever part of the world that you're in. It could be afternoon, it could be midnight for some of you, but wherever you are around the diaspora, well, just you stay tuned and enjoy this wonderful episode of Dreams Come True. For those of you that are joining us for the first time, Dreams Come True is about the biggest youth empowering talk show on television, and I'm your host, Jazzyb. I don't want to let the cat out of the bag. I just want you to stay tuned and enjoy this wonderful, wonderful episode.
Hey! What's going on, people? Look, I'm gonna take you through this dance here. It's easy. I swear that. Stay with the icy watch. Let me pull you through it. First step is take your right hand. Next step is take your left hand. And then I put my hand in the air. And then I show you the migraine sky.
You know the song that I will play to beat Kaffy now? You know my song. Ha! Hey!
I like it.
My mind says I should not dance.
I like it.
Dreams come true.
Kaffy. Everybody knows you as Kaffy. Even me, I know Kaffy. But we don't know if it is...
They know.
Kaffy what?
Yes. My names are Kafayat Oluwatoyin Shafao.
How did you now shorten it to Kaffy?
Well, it's not my fault. First of all, most of my clients at a particular point in my life were expatriates and foreigners. So to pronounce the name was a problem. I have been giving like 10,000.
Just 10,000 give us one example of their pronunciation.
So it just got to a point like this is Kaffy, but I got into trouble at home because I come from a very, you know, strict Muslim background. So you see my uncle say, hello, hello, baby. So I want to talk to Kaffy, because Kaffy, let me. So when I go home, I go like, come,
Did you redo your naming ceremony? I don't understand because they're asking for somebody else inside the house and the person is bearing a name similar to your own.
Mm-hmm.
I said, oh, daddy, Kaffy, right? Kaffy, what? It's a nickname. I said, why is it a nickname? Why can't they shorten your name? Should be your full name is Kafaya. Uh-huh. Why can't they say Kafa? Or Kaya or Ayat?
Have you ever acted before?
No. Maybe a school plays, yeah.
Mm. Okay, maybe we're going to invite you to come and be part of our movie soon because it's flowing in your blood. How long have you been dancing? Before you did the Guinness Book of Records thing, how long, how many years had you probably you've been into dance before that Guinness Book of Records?
Since I was like 5, 6 years old.
Mm. How did this start?
It just started with, I think it's music really.
Mm-hmm.
The love for music, and I grew up with parents that are very into music. You know, I grew up with a lot of, you know, 60s, 70s music, into Fuji, Juju, you know, Afrobeat. You know, so I think it's an inborn thing to be able to move to the rhythm, but I had to develop the skills as I grew up.
Mm.
So it's just natural. I'm surprised myself because most of the times when I was a little, I would go into birthday parties and people just go and sit down. And I'm like, okay, I don't shit for bodini. I be the clothes on tear for side. I don't understand because I was really shy because I was wondering why when I dance, people just go and sit down.
You like shy?
Yeah, very. I'm still kind of. Yes.
Okay, go on.
Okay, so and it's just an inborn thing.
But wait, you said that time like 60s, 70s kind of music. Which of those 60s, 70s was your...
My dad is everywhere. He's,
which one did you like, you personally?
I loved Aruna Shola.
Sing the one you like.
Hey,
don't go.
Hey, I'm in trouble. The tune is in my... Okay, I like this one. Let me tell you another one I love.
Okay.
Because they kept repeating... Because we grew up in England. So when we got back, Yoruba was very strange.
Mm.
So I hear something over and over again. I like this, board members, board members, Awani, Omola, yeah. I can't remember. La, 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 la.
We understand. Well, I know board members.
Ebenezer Obey.
Mm.
Yes.
Mm? So how did that inspire? How? Because that kind of music... Dancing to it.
No, first of all, it's not the music that inspired the dance, really. The dance is just an inborn ability to do something.
Mm.
You understand? What inspired me dancing to this level is the reason why you brought me here today.
Yeah.
You understand?
And what's that?
And that is a journey.
Mm.
A journey of wanting something, desiring, and a hunger. A hunger for relevance. A hunger for...
Hunger for relevance.
Relevance, really. Relevance in the sense that I grew up highly spiritual as a kid. Even my parents had to stop me from fasting at 5. What is your problem? Somehow there's this connect with God that has always been instilled in me ever since I was a kid. Because my parents, I considered at that period, very confused spiritually. There's no way I have not been with them. From Orimila to Ayilala to Shongo to Sele, Anglican, Kianes. They were... everywhere.
Because they didn't know which was...
Yes, but the ministration I got was just from one God. And that was the tool that kept me going in my pursuit for happiness.
Mm.
You understand? So basically for me, dance is just part of that. I am the kind of person, I'm like water. I see myself as water.
Mm.
Nothing can stop me. I must find a way out of something.
Explain, because they say, Kaffy, Omo Mini.
No, not Omo Mini kind of water.
Explain.
It's just an expression. When I say water is that situations come up in life. There is no way, as long as you are breathing, you're a human being, that there is no other alternative for you to get out of that problem. We were not built to go through sufferings without having the ability to get out of it.
Mm, say that's it again.
We're not built that way, to go into suffering without the ability to come out of it. The moment God gives you a problem more than your own, that means you are a dead man. That means you are dead. It's impossible for we to have. So those are the little things that I grew up, philosophies that I grew up with. And you know, my parents split up at a very young age, so I was basically on my own to train from 13. I ran away from my mom at 16 because I didn't want to be a prostitute. She was encouraging. she was encouraging prostitution to a level.
Pause. Did you hear that? She ran away from her mom because her mom was encouraging her to go into prostitution. Her mom.
So basically, from that period, I knew that I wanted to.
Slow down. Your mom was encouraging you to go into prostitution and you ran away. Some people on the street today, if you talk, I talk to a few of them, trying to like talk them out of what they're doing, and they tell me they have to survive, and they think the only way to survive is to live by prostitution. I'm happy you are here. I didn't know this about you, Kaffy. I'm so happy. Go on.
Okay, so basically, when my mom and dad split up, there was this custody thing battle. So we had to stay with our mom most of the time. And growing up with our mom was hell, you know, because of the things she was doing wrong that was not suitable for growing children at that period. And those were also my most important and cherished moments, because those are the things that made me who I am today. I'm a kind of person that... Can I stand up and talk? Okay, thank you. I'm a kind of person that... I don't see negativities. I automatically automated. I transform it to positive things. For instance, if you ask me to sweep this whole hall out of wickedness, I will take the broom and I will sweep it. I'll say, okay, by the time I finish, man, my six packs go down, come out. Oh, my legs go down strong. I don't want to look at it from the angle of why you're doing it to me. I'm going to look at it from the angle of, okay, it's been said and done. Do it, but let me see how much benefit I'm going to gain from the experience positively. Do we understand? And that's basically how I live through with my mother. You understand? It's not easy. I'm going through this because a lot of us have parents at home that are like that. It's not their fault. It's just, I think if they had people talking to them growing up as well, they would have avoided some of these mistakes. You understand? It's as simple as your mother saying you will not go to school unless you dream. If you no dream, you can't go to school. Is that not funny? Like, if you no dream, everybody know what I mean by dream now. Dream, sleep, dream. To the extent that the only time you can have quality time of sleeping is for you to form a dream. All you need to do is... She's very dream crazy. She's like, Kabaya, come on, go make sure you go to some hotel. Mommy, mo la la kon lowo. One girlie. Sokpada, mumba. That was how bad it was. That was how bad. But as I said, spiritually, I hated that. It's like you're enslaving me to do this continuously. So I just felt, I am going to see. Mom, see, I no dream today. No dream. Oh, lucky me. Oh, God, mommy, me worry anything. I didn't see any. So you have different situations like that, you know. And going through school was the same thing. Nothing is written in stone. My experiences are divided in different situations that concern our youths of today. If you are talking about, I'm not going to school because there's no money, I've been in that situation. In fact, my teachers paid my school fees through most of the time. I didn't get an opportunity of going into GS2, GS3, SS1, SS2 until mostly 3 years after. I was self-taught. I had to read at home. All I knew was that I had friends, neighbors that go to school and they have textbooks. So what I do is I go there. That's not an excuse for me not to read. I have gotten the primary education. I can read. That's the most important thing. Thank you. I could read. So, and I had a desire, what I wanted to read, what I wanted to study. And I was like, okay, I want to be an aeronautic engineer. And I chose that for a reason. Civil, mechanical, electrical, they're everywhere. I was concerned about the sector of our country that I'll probably be more relevant. And I felt that the aviation industry needed more technicians. I just looked at where we lacked the most, and I wanted to impact from that angle. And that's what brought up wanting to be an aeronautic engineer. And I had to study for that. And I don't have a parent that is encouraging me. If I want to read, I have to enter a basket and read. Or I get flogged for reading. You understand?
You enter where?
A basket. I don't know. Something.
The same Kaffy that is standing here.
Yeah, of course. I've sold bottle in the railway. I've farmed.
wait. Ego, let's talk about it.
Ego, Coke, Coke was like 5 naira.
Huh?
If you sell stout, you have plenty money. Stout was 15 naira. And it will buy me a plastic of Gary. That's why Gary is my best food. Nobody can tell me Gary did not make me survive. I survived on Gary for 3 months consecutively. There was no atom or any atom of kwashoko. Do you know why? Because the state of mind wasn't suffering.
Give it up for that feature.
It's the biggest and most empowering hit talk show on TV. Dreams come true with Jazzyb. Highly entertaining, purely educating, and touching true stories. Let's learn from their dreams, their fears, the struggles, the disappointments, the failures, and their gains. All because of their dreams. But after all, their dreams came to reality. Dreams Come True Talk Show with Jazzyb on this channel. It's the biggest and most empowering hit talk show on TV. Dreams Come True with Jazzyb. Highly entertaining, purely educating, and touching true stories. Let's learn from their dreams, their fears, the struggles, the disappointments, the failures, and their gains. All because of their dreams. But after all, their dreams came to reality. Dreams Come True Talk Show with Jazzyb on this channel.
All these things taught me a lot of stuff about life. But the most important thing is that I do not want to die for nothing. I don't want to come to life, grow up, have kids, and it's like you just came, your name was just there, and you died for nothing. It's
where did you get that sickening mentality from?
I don't know. It's the grace of God. I don't know. It's not, I can't imagine not doing anything that has to do with touching somebody else's life. And that's how I started developing the skills that has to do with relating with somebody else. And that's when my focus started changing from aeronautics to something more direct.
Mm.
And it didn't change from aeronautics because I didn't want to. It changed because it was frustrated and I had to look for another channel. I got like 3 or 4 scholarships. I was considered an A-class student in my house.
Huh.
I started speaking at a very young age. If my father calculated by 17, you should be out of university. That's how much. And things happen. And 25, I ain't out of university yet. In fact, I'm struggling through it.
Mm.
You understand? But the knowledge that as I've accumulated, even some 60 years old have not gotten all that. They don't understand life to that extent yet. You understand? So it's not really about what you do, how you do. You must want it.
Mm.
You understand?
Kaffy, come again. It's not about what you do
or how you do it. You must want it. Yeah. There's no recipe in terms of, okay, there's a secret template. And the template is when you go A, B, C. It doesn't work for everybody like that. We're all destined differently. A lot of, I grew up a lot self-taught, but because of what I see.
Mm.
You know, and self-taught in a way, as I said, with the guidance of God, it has played a major role. I cannot stop talking about it. It was very relevant, honestly. Because the level of morality that I had to keep or sustain to be able to live through that dirt, you require much more than your ability to say no. You require a higher ability, a higher realm to keep you in check, keep you in control.
Mm.
True. Somebody might somewhere hate you, plan something, but they do not, cannot, and will not be your the caretaker of your soul. You are the caretaker of your soul. Nobody is going to go to hell for you or heaven for you. Nobody's going to do it. You're going to do it. So nobody can do you except God's allowed that do to happen. You know, God must allow it to happen. It doesn't just happen. So you need to recognize when God is using negative things to try to guide you or educate you towards something greater in future. You never know. It's always a trial. So if God can love you and tell Abraham to go and sacrifice his son, then we are bound to go through trials. Person do amo, person no do amo, you go enter am. So the key to everything is you. They do you for school, Abby. Say, make you no pass. Keep on praying and keep on reading. Does that stop you from reading? Then they have won.
Let's talk about this Guinness Book of Records thing. How did you wake up with that idea? How did you think it was possible to break? You didn't even say you want to break Nigerian record or African record. You wanted to set a world record. How did you come about the idea?
Point of correction. Mm. There's no human being that wake up in the morning and say, I want to just be dancing for 3 days. Like she will.
Mm-hmm.
I never planned it to.
So how did it happen?
I just did that. As in, it's just Ben Bruce. Okay, from the course of dancing, 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 which we'll still talk about how it actually happened later. Yeah. He just called me. He just said, young woman, how long do you think you can dance for? I said, no, do you know what? My greatest gift is my mind. When I put up my mind at something, there's no limit. Even I don't know how long. It's just a matter of, let's try it, if it works, if it doesn't
work. Once you set your mind on it.
That thing is extremely difficult. If calculated, it takes approximately, let's say, 11 days for the human being's body to die without sleep. That is, you mustn't have insomnia for 11 days straight. You're going to go wankers or die. Now, you're going to dance 3 out of that 11 days. That means you are 1/3 away from death. You are 3 steps, just 3 steps away from death. So that's why people were losing their minds in the... And the dance. Somebody be dancing like this now. First, let us dance. We're in the same group. Let's dance. Just as I stop, just say, ah, oh, do you want to
Kaffy, oh, do you want? Oh, do you
want? Oh,
in his mind, he's dancing. Oh.
But his body?
His body is not moving. Right? Leave me. Don't you see how I'm doing it? I said, we are going to lose if you don't. The other guy was like, Simon, 1 second momentary stop, you are out. I'm dancing, please. You have to catch me. I'm dancing. I'm coming.
So you're spending, now imagine your body has to dance 24 hours. I realized it was a long time. 24 hours. Man!
Umwago.
As in, like, one new talent I've acquired to emphasize something. Man, it was a long time! Because you have to develop both mental, you have to have physical fitness, mental fitness. I had to create a time zone in my mind away from the real time zone. 6 hour clock. My body's not going to check the clock until 6 hours after. You're only allowed to rest after you've danced for 1 hour. Believe me, after dancing 6 hours straight, that 1 hour is a long time. You'll be dancing like this. 6:05. Let me just, I'm coming. 6:05. In my mind now, I've danced like 40 minutes. Look at the time. 6:06.
Dreams come true.
And dance is inspired by drugs. It's very simple. It's a medical thing. Dance,
Drugs cannot inspire your dance. That's the first thing you need to know. It's not a spirit or a person to inspire you to do something. You are taking it because probably you're trying to increase your stamina or fitness or whatever. It's a drug. What I think the question is driving at is, would you do drugs because you want to last longer on stage, you understand, and probably enhance your dance? It doesn't even add to your style. A drug is not going to teach you how to break. It's not. You want to last longer? Maybe, yes. There are performance enhancers. That's why there are legal ones and there are illegal ones. Legal performance enhancers are your vitamins. You understand? Most of the good vitamins you cannot really get enough of. Vitamin C's and vitamin D's and calcium for strong bones. Your glucosamine for flexibility of your joints. Those are vitamins that your body will require for dancing. But for drugs, deadly drugs like cocaine or heroin to make you high, or alcohol inducing your state of mind, that is exactly it. It only induces your state of mind and it will wear off. So the moment the drug wears off, where is your talent?
Can you combine singing with dancing?
I've actually done that. That's a surprise I had for you guys.
It's the biggest and most empowering youth talk show on TV. Dreams come true with Jazzyb. Highly entertaining, purely educating, and touching true stories. Let's learn from their dreams, their fears, the struggles, the disappointments, the failures, and their gain. All because of their dreams. But after all, their dreams came to reality. Dreams Come True Talk Show with Jazzyb on this channel.
I'm a geek, let me see if I'm chillin' on the floor, let me see if I'm chillin' on the floor.